Hey, Amanda, you just called me. Are you guys all right? I do. I was in the bathroom in Starbucks when you called, but I'm out in my vehicle now.
If you had a few minutes to talk, because, you say that we don't support you and all this is massive, but me and Mom have watched almost every, well, you know what, between us, we watched every single video you've put up, okay? And these recent videos are a little disturbing, seeing how you say that the only reason we get to keep our place is because Mom's a weed dealer. Now, what
I thought
kind of
you
crap
wanted
is that?
to
That's
have
not
me talk.
true. That's not true at all.
How
Mom
much
is on the medical
weed?
marijuana program, which is legal in our state, and Section 8 helps us pay for our house because we are low income. So that's not okay
I
for you to
said
say
that.
those kind
I
of
said
lies.
that. I said
And if we aren't hurt by healing,
your mom gets paid from the state. I also said you get paid $11 an hour, which is what you told
to
me.
take care of her so that I cook her food, I do her laundry,
And
clean
she
her
can cook her
house.
food and
I
do
put
her own
medicine on her.
laundry.
I give her shots 3 times a week
She can cook
for
her
her
food
MS.
and do her own laundry, can she not?
She cannot cook an actual meal. Like, she can't cook with oil on the stove. She almost lit a fire, Sean. That's why I have to do all the cooking.
So
She can
she's a
put a
bad
meal
cook.
in the
It's not
microwave
that
in
she
30
can't cook,
seconds.
it's that she's not any
Sure.
good at it.
Microwavable stuff, but that makes her have allergic breakouts. So, and then 2 weeks, not even 2 weeks after you left, she ended up breaking her back. There's just things that
That's
you
the
don't
thing, is
see,
that
and
I
then you
have
make
just as
assumptions
many things
for,
fucked up with me as
and
your
a lot
mother.
of
That's the thing.
assumptions make
You
assholes out of
asked
everybody.
me if I had time to talk. You're doing all of the talking, Amanda.
But you're not listening, are you? So I just
That's
wanted
the
a little bit
point,
to talk to
is that
benefit for all the
I,
listening. I have to listen to all
Amanda,
your
the last
videos and
time
record
that
what
I
you have to
listened
say
to your
about us.
mother talk,
And
I
this is
didn't
on the
get a
side of
word
our
in
business, so
edgewise. Goodbye.
stop them listening, okay?
That's the issue that I have. Sean, do you have a few minutes to talk? Well, yes, I do. But if you're going to do all the talking, then no, I don't. Lana being a bad cook ain't got nothing to do with me. She's capable of cooking. I've seen her do it. Now, if she can't cook anything with oil, how is it that she can eat something with oil? If she almost started a fire, that's a matter of her not paying attention to what she's doing, more so than being incapable of doing so. Believe it or not, I've lit grease fires before. Now, as far as her getting free money, yeah, she does get free money. She lives with her mother and gets paid $11 an hour to live with her mother. Now, I don't know about you guys, but when I lived with my mother, I did all of my own cooking. And I did the cooking for my brothers and sisters quite often as well. I didn't get paid $11 an hour for it. Now, as far as the medical marijuana thing goes, they're getting a several million dollar property. Section 8 housing isn't going to pay for that. There's no way in hell. Several million dollars. How do you end up with Section 8 in a place that costs several million dollars? It's a good question. So she didn't call for me to talk. She called for her to talk. Now she did the same thing that Lana did and Miss Jerry did, and the same thing that she did to me last time. Except this time I hung up on her. See, when Lana called me, She did all the talking, and she was a complete and total bitch. When it was my turn to talk, she went out of her way to insult me and then hung up. Not okay. She pretended she was listening to what I said, but she was just waiting for her opportunity to go out of her way to be a jerk. Now, Miss Jerry, on the other hand, she called me up and she was screaming from the moment she got on the phone until the moment that she hung up. And Amanda, when she called me, it was the same day that I talked to Miss Jerry and Miss Lana. And she was the only one that didn't go off on a screaming rant. She just kept on talking and talking and talking and then hung up on me. And it was probably a grand total of 2 minutes nonstop talking, which is actually quite a bit compared to 2 minutes of typing. But I was on the phone listening to Miss Jerry yell at me for probably 10 to 15 minutes. And I was yelling back. What I had to say doesn't matter. And that's the point, is that these people already have a place. There's more than one income there. They're getting help with it. Lana has some of the same issues that I do as far as having a fucked up back. She's had degenerative disc disease longer than me. And I feel bad for her because of that. The problem is, you don't get to call me to bitch me out if you're not willing to hear what I have to say. No, I'm not willing to hear what she has to say. Because she has already shown me that what I have to say does not matter. I'm gonna call her back and give her the chance to listen. Maybe she'll answer some questions for me. If she does that, then I'll listen to what she has to say. But I've done enough of the listening. You can't help me if you're not willing to find out the situation. Now, these people don't like what I have to say. I don't give a fuck. How do you get a several million dollar piece of property on Section 8? That's what I'd like to know. It sucks that she broke her back. If they called me up today and said, "Hey, Sean, she's pretty fucked up and we need your help up here," I would probably still go up there and help them. But I'm stupid like that. Kind of like after all the hell that Natalie put me through. And her friends and her family. When she disappeared, I still was worried about her and I still wanted to find her. I wanted her to be safe. I knew how risky she was. How risky a situation it was. The problem is, on Facebook, it was a bunch of fucking wingnuts going at me for shit that they weren't there for. And the courts going out of their way to judge me before I ever made it into the court. I was already guilty in their minds before I ever stepped foot in a courtroom. I went to over 20 court dates. Over 20. Before I finally had to do something drastic, because I didn't have the money to keep going to those court dates for them to continue it and continue it and continue it and not do their goddamn jobs and not look at the goddamn evidence. I literally took that bag of evidence everywhere that I went until August when it was stolen by Officer Brian Valenzuela. Maybe Amanda should have, well, she called up and asked if I wanted to talk. Yes, I want to talk. I want it to be my turn to talk this time. And if I get to talk, then she gets to talk. They don't like what I had to say. Maybe they shouldn't have been as judgmental as they were. Maybe they should have kept their word. Maybe they should have asked me what I was doing instead of just assuming. See, that's the problem. If people aren't there to see it, you must not be trying. That's why I needed someone to go in with me to talk to the police. So that somebody was there to witness that I was fucking trying. And if the police did the same thing with other people there that they did when I was by myself, at least I had a witness. But I couldn't get one. Miss Shelley, that's one of Natalie's stepmothers. She claimed that a woman named Erica was going to come and help me. She never showed up. This Erica lady was supposed to call me. She never called. She's not the only one who did that. That's the thing, is that I needed help, not empty promises. Now with Rayanna, the last time I came up here, it was pretty expensive and I didn't have the money to do so, but I was hoping, because I needed a safe place. And she knows me very well. Or at least she used to. Time changes things, you know? Rihanna didn't tell me until after I'd already expended the resources to get here that her husband was not okay with it. That would have been a nice thing to know before making the trip. With that shit up there in Montana, I wasn't allowed to speak. It was always like that. Always them talking. It's always their turn to talk. No, I'm done listening because they won't listen. These people don't like that I expose their secrets. Lana and Amanda get a lot of help that I don't get. Like I said, Amanda lives with her mother. She gets paid to live with her mother. She gets paid to do the things that you have to do anyway. She gets more money per month for pretending to babysit her mom than her mom gets for disability. And so neither one of them have to actually work. And neither one of them have to actually work.